guest is in his fourth season playing Wyoming Sheriff Walt Longmire in the Western series Longmire. Please welcome actor Robert Taylor to our home. Cowboy actor and your point of view?
Yeah, I guess the standards, you know, Gary Cooper, Clint Eastwood, I mean, they're pretty safe choices.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're safe, but they're good choices,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
How do you prepare? Because you have that rough and tumble look about you.
Thanks for
you.
Yeah. And your voice.
In a good way.
Everything about you, your voice, everything.
Did life prepare you for that? Or
a little bit, yeah.
How so?
Well, I just got old, you know?
That's not what I meant.
That's not.
No, I mean, have you had those tough jobs?
I've had a couple. When I was young, I worked different jobs. I was a ranger. I worked oil rigs, worked in the mines, and I just got sick of working for a living, and I thought.
Well, later on, we're going to get into the topic of all the really odd and dangerous jobs that you also had before you became an actor.
Our next guest is playing his fourth season as Wyoming Sheriff Walt Longmire in the acclaimed Western series Longmire. Please welcome, as he takes a sip, actor Robert Taylor.
I thought those donuts were amazing.
Pretty good. They're so good. Yeah. So tell us about getting to play your sheriff.
Well, it's every kid's dream, right?
Right.
I mean, it took a long time coming, but I get to. Well, I don't ride horses so much, but I ride an old Bronco and get to wear my 1911 pistol and wear a big hat, so it's pretty good.
But a sheriff has a swagger. Do they not, or do you try not?
It's got to be a little bit.
The iconic ones that I would...
Yeah, they do.
James Arnaz from Gunsmoke and all, they all had that.
You got to have your personal walk.
Right, right.
Yeah, and you have a lot of personal things, too, because you have your own personal little belt buckle, too, that I understand that you picked up in the 90s that you've had all these years. Tell us a little bit about that.
Do you have it? I'll
show you.
You wear it all the time.
This one here.
Yeah, that there you go.
Well, that's become like your symbol.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
It was just holding my pants up.
When you're not on the range.
Well, this saved me a lot of embarrassment, I can tell you. I got it at the Taos Pueblo in, I think, about 91 or 92, and I've worn it pretty much every day of my life, except if I'm on the beach, because that'd be weird. Mosquitoes.
Well, we expect to see that on you, because it's synonymous with
your
character.
Did someone tell you it was weird after you did the first time?
Yeah.
How you figured that? We're going to see a clip. What are we going to see in this?
I think this is the opening scene of season four. Mm-hmm. At the end of season three, I've figured out who killed my wife, and I'm going to take care of him.
Ooh.
So this is where it opens.
Okay,
let's take a look. So keep your calm.
I cannot do that.
Suit yourself. I'll just use this one.
I do not think this is what Martha would want.
Well, I'll never know.
If you fire that gun now, he will kill everything that you have ever stood for. We have been given a second chance, Walker. Both of us. I will not let you ruin it by shooting night horse out of the sky.
I was planning on waiting for him to land.
That took some acting, I can tell you, because making it look like Luke had put up a good fight really took some acting. Sorry, Luke.
Is the person on the plane who killed your wife?
I think so.
Yeah. There are other people
you
on
better
plane
know,
too,
you,
Sheriff.
I'm just arresting this guy for dusting the wrong crop.
Okay.
No, he's on the plane.
Yeah.
We were talking a little bit about some of the jobs that you've had that toughened you up earlier in the show. Mm-hmm. There was one. You said you were an oil rig?
Yeah, I worked rigs for a bunch of years.
That's not an easy job.
No, I think acting is the toughest job I ever did, but tough trying to get a job.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, that'll harden anybody up. But yeah, I worked offshore for a bunch of years when I was a kid.
On an oil rig?
Drill ships, semis, jackups, all kinds of platforms.
Did you have any harrowing experiences on the rig or on the ocean? What?
Well, on the rig ending up in the ocean, yeah, we had a few experiences. We storms and cyclones, and at one stage we sunk the biggest ship sunk in the Eastern Indian Ocean since World War II, and that took some doing. It wasn't
you
easy.
Sunk it?
We sunk it.
Did you use that
me
gun?
And three other guys. No, we we collided with this ship. We're on a rig move in the middle of the night. And,
really?
That's pretty harrowing.
Yeah, but I was a kid. I was, you know, I was 19. I thought it was...
thought it was cool?
I shouldn't say hilarious, but... I thought it was pretty funny.
If you'd been in your Speedo with the belt buckle, didn't that, that would have been...
Well, hilarious. That's right.
That would have been hilarious. Any other jobs that have toughened you up? Or at least
I worked as a ranger, but not a forest ranger. I patrolled the beach. So I was in charge of, in Australia, and I had about 15 miles of beach. And that was, I mean, all I did all day was surf and fish, meet girls, which was great, until somebody drowned. Everything changed pretty quickly.
I'm sure.
Yeah, because you're responsible for everybody's safety. So.
Yeah.
Sure. You're also responsible at certain times of the year for little children's happiness, I understand.
Yeah, you have a very soft side to you, too, that I don't think people know about.
We have a picture, and this will further explain exactly what we're talking about. But take a look.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. This is...
what are we looking at?
Well, that's... I live on that street, and that... well, that's the end of my street, and that was some parkland that the government, in their wisdom, decided they were going to... rezone and sell off for development. And I personally believe you shouldn't be selling parkland. It belongs to everyone, children and whoever. So, you know, I got together with a couple of people and we worked on it for a bunch of years. I'm president of that place. It's a garden, studios, workshops. I've been president for 15 years and we have a lot of events. It's become a bit of a model. You know, we just had Singapore National Parks there studying us. And we're self-funding. We run all these programs, and we pay for different programs in different countries. So it's fun for me to do.
Well, listen, we're going to have a little fun for you to do
right
now. Because we're playing a little game, because we want to see how well you can, ready for this, rate your mates. Okay, there's your, come on over. We're going to see how this works, okay? Here's how we're going to do this. We have a couple of... heights here from 2.5 feet all the way through up to 6 feet 7 inches tall. Okay, I'm gonna randomly hand you some of your mates, and you're gonna see if you can put them in the correct size. So we're gonna start with Crocodile Dundee. How tall is he?
Hoax is he'll probably tell you he's 5'9", but I think he's more like 5'7".
Okay. Well, you can put him up. I'm gonna, like, if you want to change, I got the sweetheart of Olivia Newton-John. Where's she gonna fall in here?
She's got to be shorter.
She's got to be shorter than that. But then we got Nicole Kidman.
Oh, Nick. She's my friend.
All right, let's see where you're gonna put Russell Crowe.
Rusty. Oh, he's down here, dude.
Is he that short person?
We all used to live together, a bunch of Australians here. In
You did?
Yeah.
You didn't live with a koala bear. Where's that one gonna go? Okay. Here you have one of the most talented and nice guys.
Hugh
Jackman.
One of the nicest guys you'll ever meet.
Right? Yeah, he really is.
Is he 6'2 or is he 6 foot?
Well, I can give you a clue. There's also, you also have Dame Edna, if you want to put Dame Edna there.
That's Barry Humphries.
And we have a Kylie Minogue, too. So you can, you may want to rotate through some of these.
Yeah, I may want it.
Perfect.
Okay.
Yep.
He's going to kill me if I... Who's 6'7"?
You've got a red cape.
Oh, the big, that's a big red.
There you go.
Big red.
Okay.
I want to say, is this with the shoes on or off?
I don't know.
I'm going to have to, I'm going to put her with shoes on.
All right, let's go down the line.
He's tall.
Let's see if we've got these right. At 2.5 feet, you got the koala bear right. Is Kylie Minogue 5? Yes, she is. Olivia Newton-John, 5'6"? Yes, you're right. Crocodile Dundee, let's see. Wow, you know your mates. Russell. I got that one wrong. Let's see, Nicole Kidman. You got that right. This must be Russell. There you go. And Hugh Jackman. And, of course, wow, you only got those two. You know your mates, mate.
He's in New Zealand.
That's right, he is. Be sure to check out Robert in season 4 of Longmire. It is now streaming on Netflix. We're going to...